Navigation in SwiftUI is confusing, to say the least. There's navigation stack and sheets and navigation link and values. It is a mess. So let's fix it. In this tutorial series, I'm going to cover the most efficient and elegant way of using navigation in SwiftUI. From links to sheets, from values to navigation destinations, we are going to cover it all. So let's jump right in. And if you'd like to hire me on a one-on-one session, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, today is the first of a series where we are going to digest and make navigation super fun and easy in SwiftUI. So for that, I have just started a Xcode project with some files already added in here. As you can see, we have our content view. It has a tab view. It has root one view, root two view. Here is a root one view and root two view with some notes here, what I have to do today. And then we have destination one view and destination to view. Today we are going to talk about how you can make your navigation decoupled from the view with the help of enums. And we are going to continue on that, so make sure that you subscribe to the channel and maybe like this video also if you do enjoy it, because there is more to come. This is the first in a series. So what do we want to do? Well, we are not going to use the default navigation stack, either with a path or without a path, with the navigation link. We want to decouple all of that from the views. And the easiest way of doing that is through creating some sort of a coordinator, router, slash enum, because that is what we are going to use as our building block. So let's create a new file. And I added the tab view so you can see that we have to create all of these enums for the different navigation stack destinations, so-called. But you will see why this project is starting as it is. So let's click on the file art over here. Let's click on next. And what we are going to do right over here is specify some values. Most probably you already seen some navigation stack tutorials where we have some values. Well, this is where we are going to set them up. So I'm going to name this appropriately. So it will be root one. So it's the navigation stack for our root one tab view. And navigation link values. Navigation link values. Because all of these destinations will be added onto a navigation link. Okay, so that's our file. And let's import SwiftUI. We are going to need that. And let's create our enum. And that will be our root one navigation link values. And because we are going to use this inside the navigation destination, this has to be hashable. So there you go. And then, because we want to set all of our destination views right over here inside the enum, this will be a view. It's really, really interesting, right? So let's have two cases in this enum. So case destination one, and then case destination two. And for destination two, we are going to use dependency injection. So you rest assured that you know how to do that. Currently, I'm just going to add in a title, and that is of type string. But of course, you can add in any hashable right over here, any hashable model that you might want to push through the destination to. Okay, so those are the two cases. Now it's time to add our actual views. It's as simple as that. As a passionate iOS developer aiming to advance your skills, partnering with me as a mentor through rebeloper.com/mentoring could significantly impact your career trajectory. Armed with extensive industry experience and a profound comprehension of iOS development, I offer invaluable perspectives, hands-on expertise, and effective strategies to navigate the complexities of app creation. Prioritizing practical abilities, current industry insights, and streamlined coding methodologies, I am dedicated to equipping you with the knowledge and proficiency essential for success in the dynamic realm of iOS development. Come join me at rebeloper.com/mentoring, and together, let's elevate your journey in iOS development. So as you can see, we are not conforming to the view protocol just yet. What we need to do is add our body. And here it is, our body. And now we need to switch through all of our cases. So let's just go switch, self, and I'm going to use Xcode auto completion right over here. So it's helping me out really nicely. We have destination 1 and 2. And right over here, we are going to add destination 1 view. And then right over here, destination 2 view. And I'm moving the title forward. So into the destination 2 view. And that's it. It's really as simple as it gets. Now, let's move forward and let's see would we actually use this route 1 navigation link, these values. So let's go to our route 1 view. And here we would just add a navigation link to the destination 1 view. So let's just add it. So let's just see a navigation link. And we are going to use the one with the value and label. You could just use the title key and value, but yeah, whatever you see fit. Make sure that you are using the one with the value. So the value, here comes the really, really fun part. It will be root one, what's it called? Oh, root. let's rephrase that, rename that, because I see that I made a typo right over here. Refactor, rename. It has to be root instead of root. Oh, really nice. Okay, so let's go back to our root one view, command that back in, and then root one destination. Well, it's not auto completing. I'm just going to, not destination, navigation link. So root one navigation link values dot, and where do I want to navigate over here? Well, to destination one. And then the label, let's have a text right over here of destination one view. I'm just going to copy and paste it right over there. So that's one. And now I also want to show you how you can move the actual title, dependency injection. We are going to set the navigation link on the destination one view to move to the destination two view. And right over here, let's just have again the value and label, and that will be a root a one navigation link values dot. And now we just choose the destination two view and the title, let's just say it's Ada, and then the label, again, a simple text to show where we are actually going to go. Okay, this is how we move. This is how we navigate. It's really, really straightforward. Now, we do have to set all of this up because, you know, this isn't set up inside a navigation stack at all just yet. So let's do that. Let's go to the content view. And as you can see, we have root one view and the tab item. What we want to do is add this into a navigation stack, of course, as usual. And then on the navigation stack, we want to set up our navigation destinations. And of course, if you are a little bit familiar with navigation stack, you want to add it onto the root of the navigation stack. So we just say navigation destination, and we are going to use the one for and destination. So the for, that is our root, root one navigation link values dot self. And usually what you would do as a next step, you would just hit return, and that would just make this hashable available, and according to the value you would just navigate away somewhere. But remember, we don't have to do that in this case because we have our body. So we just add in these two brackets and then $0. So it will use itself. So the value is a hashable, which is fine. It will use itself. Why I mean by itself? Well, because it's a view. According to the case, it will just use itself. It's really, really straightforward. Okay, so now let's build and run, and let's see if we made everything set up correctly. And if we do, we are going to have also a view extension which will make this a little bit easier. So here we have tab one, tab view, that's nice. Destination one view, it's working. Destination two view, it's moved either into that view. And we can just go back over there, which is really, really nice. Okay, so that's fine. But what if I want to add this also to the root view controller? So I create another root, two navigation link values, then put it in the navigation stack, set the navigation destination. And this is kind of encrypted, you know, not many developers know about this. So let's just create a view extension on this. So I'm going to create a new file right over here, call it a view plus. View plus, so it's an extension on the view. We do need to import SwiftUI right over here, and it's an extension on the view. There we go. And I'm just going to add in here our navigation link values. So that function will be called navigation link values. And we are going to add in some type of data. You will see in just a second. I'm going to name this D. Of type D, and then a data, and that will be D.type. There we go. And we are going to return some view, and here we need to specify what this D is. So where D is hashable and view. Basically, that's it. Now I can just go and Now I can go back to our content view and try to replicate all of this stuff. So first of all, we need a navigation stack. And inside the navigation stack, we are going to use self because this view modifier will be added to a certain view. We're going to use self dot and then navigation destination for. What's the hashable? Well, that's the data. And the destination, well, that will be again $0. It's really, really nice. Now we can go back and on the content view, we can just replace all of this mumbo jumbo. So let me just comment this out so you will be able to see it later on. I'm just going to use root one view and then navigation link values. There we go, navigation link values, and just provide that protocol. So root navigation link values dot self. Much nicer, if I do say so myself. Okay, this is as easy as it gets. Now we have decoupled navigation, but we did not cover sheets. So if you want to know how we are going to add sheets to this, make sure that you subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell to get notified, and we are going to cover sheets and some more in the next episode. And if you'd like to meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring.